Good evening, people. So, I am an Android developer, basically mobile application developers, mainly into Android and BlackBerry for past around 2 years. So, I'll be speaking on Android enterprise application development, device administration API, mainly for developers. So, this is 2011. Android has been in limelight since 2009 start. You know about the donut period that Google I am, the first device from Google. That time Android was not so glamorous with tough fight with iPhone and BlackBerry in stats. But today scenario has changed. I don't need to give you any stats in marketplace or anything. It has been wonderful. Besides games and beautiful applications, there is a different world in Android universe, and that is Android enterprise applications. So what is this Android applications, or you can say Android enterprise mobile solutions? Enterprises and mobiles. Everyone, virtually everyone, every earning person is having a mobile, one or two. Most of them are going to take, going to buy or buying smartphones, be it iPhone or Androids. In enterprises, big enterprises, IT, basically IT departments purchase mobiles in bulk and issue them to their employees, stick them to some organization policies, some censorship, and basically for what? For productivity. But people are now migrating to smartphones, and they would like to take their smartphones to work. Sometimes it may work, sometimes not. So Android is going to into that direction, to be a workplace phone. Nobody likes to have two or three mobiles, one for email, one BlackBerry for email checking and other stuff, and one for Facebook and Twitter. So criteria is one mobile only. So can an Android phone or any smartphone be can work as a business phone? There's a term which is called workplace acceptance. What is that? At workplace, as a human being, every employee has some needs, like personal needs, talking on phone and watching videos and some other stuff. Other social needs, Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, other things through mobile. And then productivity needs related to work, to make work-life balance, obviously. So, besides that, do your phone fulfill IT department requirements, the strict policies, the other things? So what they demand from your phone, the IT department? There are three things: data security, device management, applications. What are they? What is data security? Data security from loss and theft. You are using your phone, you browse your emails, sensitive information, data, important things. But suppose that get lost, that is stolen by some other person. You are an important person in your company. You are a CEO of your company, and your phone is stolen in a bar, then what will you do? Interception. You are communicating continuously through mails and talks. So every hacker or someone can intercept that communication. Sometimes you are not a good employee. Like, you are not with the best intentions for your organization. You can give away your some information, sensitive information through your mobile to any rival company. Device management, we have talked about specific registering different devices in company's network. Company wants to imply some specific security policies for organization or some general policies like email, etc. And then user support. And then company, your organization also wants to keep an eye on you. What are you doing with your phone? What type of information you are accessing through your phone? And then deploying applications to enhance productivity. So as I talked, different types of desktop utilities, softwares or web applications are now being converted into mobile applications. Like for example, last year we had a request from a salon and spa chain from Europe to convert their customer queue application, utility application, to an application, Android-based application for set-top box based on Androids as a server and iPhone and Android apps for their employees and their customers. So what the organization have to do to progress in that way? You just, as an organization, you identify apps for your employees or your customers. If they exist in market, then you buy, or otherwise you build that application, then distribute to employees. Distribution can be done through Android Market or privately, like through website or email. Just distribute that application file. Android doesn't have any direct provisioning distribution method. iPhone do have. So after distribution, you should keep updates to prevent the app to be out of date. And then usage policies. You apply usage policies. How and which employee can use that app and in which way. So where is the role of Android? How Android fits it? Right from the release of Donut and Cupcake, Android is introducing some enhancements in this direction in enterprise solutions, among which VPN support, secure Wi-Fi, exchange email normally, password, PIN lock, device policies. This is very important, device policies. We will be talking about that. This was introduced in Troyo. And then remote lock, a part of that, remote wipe API, exchange calendar, exchange active sync, and also importantly, NFC, also kind of a part of enterprise solutions, NFC for reading, writing, and peer-to-peer support, and till Gingerbread and ICS, more enhancement, like securing emails and calendars, and enhancing features of them. So you as developers want to ask, what is there for us? How can we leverage benefits of these kind of APIs, applications? According to Google, every API, as Android is open source, every API which is being used for making applications by Google, every developer, third-party developer, can use that APIs in every way, except some restrictions for security. So for developers, there is device administration API. What is that? It is introduced from Froyo 2.2. And it is for mainly security-aware apps. What is security-aware apps? Application, there is a basic application, you you introduce device administration API to, and IT people can watch you, can keep an eye on you and on its encourage and the other benefit for you as employees, the basic application plus device administration API, and you get to know the sensitive data, you get to access the sensitive information of organization, the emails and all that. So there is a two-way benefit for you and your organization. If you don't have device administration API, you don't enable those APIs, you the IT department cannot have access on your device, but other way, you cannot have that data benefit and other benefits. Third point is, for almost all type of enterprise mobile solutions, for Android-based device, you have to go through device administration API. This is important. This is kind of kernel to enterprise solutions in Android. So, device administration API and features like password policies, remote wipe, disable camera. This camera can be disabled. This has been introduced in ICS. And then enforced data encryption, remote lock. So what are they? What is password policy? So password policy, your IT department can introduce policies like what type of password you can set on your screen lock, what type of, what length, character length, should it be alphanumeric or numeric, any kind, and device password expiration time, any kind of that thing. Remote wipe. If your device gets stolen or get lost, device, the sensitive data, the emails can be wiped out and the device can be reset to factory settings just through one click over the network. Disable camera. You are on workplace, you cannot use your camera because IT department doesn't want to do that. But you are in your home, the same device, after 9 to 5, through same device, you can enable your camera, you can watch videos and all that, you can click images. Enforce data encryption. To enforce data encryption, every sensitive data on your device must be in encrypted form. That is also a kind of policy which can be forced to your device if you have enabled device administration API. And then obviously remote lock. Your IT department admin can remotely lock your device if it says that there is some malicious kind of thing being happening. So you are, for developers, APIs should be there. Three type of main APIs: device admin receiver, device policy manager, device admin info. Most important is device admin receiver, a broadcast receiver to handle all the intents related to this device administration policy. Broadcast receiver to receive the raw system events or intents, like enabling policies, if remotely or locally any new policy has been enabled on your device, or you want to enable that policy on your device, device admin receiver, a subclass of device admin receiver will do that, we handle that. Must include a subclass of this receiver in your application if you want to leverage the benefits of this whole device administration policy API. The action, the event, intent action is device admin enabled. If this application, this particular app is enabled on your device, this action would be broadcasted. This intent, the intent with this action, sorry. And then permission. User permission, you all know as Android developer. Bind device admin, this is important. And then handles the event when user enables admin application. Sorry. So how it looks like in manifest? Receiver, as we declared any broadcast receiver in our manifest, with a name, a label, a description if you want, and the permission, bind device admin. Metadata. What is metadata? It is corresponding to this third API, third class device admin info. It has all the constants, or you can say all the policies for your application. If you want to set password policies, you have to declare in metadata. Like here, I will show you. If you want to declare remote wipe or remote lock or disable camera, any kind of policies you want to declare in your app, you just have to mention that constant, that corresponding constant in metadata. Intent filter for that receiver with action device admin enabled. The code for to enable the device admin app on your device. Just a simple code, as every Android code is simple, but this is really simple. Intent, you have to declare an intent, device policy manager with action add device admin. This action will add that device admin to your application. You can add extra information, an admin receiver object. This admin receiver object is the object of that broadcast receiver you have declared. In this receiver, you have declared all these policies with the help of admin info object, admin info class. So these three APIs are connected, interconnected. Again, some explanation you want to add while your employee or your customer is installing that app and enabling your app to extend that policy. Then start activity for result. So this line, start activity for result, will show a pop-up with all the permissions, all the policies you have declared in your application. Like when the employee has just installed the app, this pop-up will occur explaining all the consequences, all the policies and consequences. And if that employee clicks active, that your application now is active on his device, and you have full control over his device through the policies you have mentioned. So it is, you have created the app, you have distributed the app as an IT admin, but it is in the hand of the employee or the customer that it should active the app or enable the app or not. If it doesn't enable the app, app is on his device, but it is inactive. It can't do anything. So here is the device admin info class corresponding to metadata. Here you can declare all the policies like limit password, what type of password you require, reset password if you want your employee to reset password during some duration, after some duration, after a month or not, or you can just force lock that device and any moment through network and wipe all the sensitive data to make the device converted to original settings, factory settings, and then expire password policy. This policy is to, if employee doesn't change his password in some duration, the password will expire and the employee will have to again reset that password according to your requirements, and then encrypted storage. If you declare that, all the data must be in encrypted form. So how does it look like, the broadcast receiver in Java? Four main methods: on enabled, then the policies are enabled on your device. This you can, what you want to do as admin, what you want to do here, you can do. Again, on disable it, press it. If the employee or yourself want to disable that all the policies. Firstly, if employee want to disable all the policies, if he wants enabled, he will have to register as admin simply. Only then he can disable those policies. If the policies are disabled, then the action will be performed in on disabled. And if a password is changed, what you want to show, what you want to do, you can do it here in this method. The second thing is, important thing is device policy manager. So this, as name, this simply manage policies. What type of policies are declared by Google in Android, what kind of policies you can leverage, this all has been defined here. Can be related to one or more admin receivers. There can be one or two or three admin policies, admin applications in your device. And one thing is important, no other application can decrease the security. Two or more applications can only increase. Like if one application has entered, has a policy to set password four digits minimum, and other has policy to set password with 6 digits minimum, then the stricter policy will be applied. That is six digit password. So you cannot make an application to counter the policies of another applications to decrease the security. Device policy manager, this is a code input. Device policy manager object, you make an object get system service, like you get access to all other managers like location manager and other things. The same way, get system service, you just declare a constant for that typecast, and you get the object for that device policy manager. You can ask it, is the admin active or not? If the response is true, you know that admin is active. And you do your required things like wipe data or locking the device, other things. Okay. So other things device policy manager can do, set all the password policies. This is the intent I have shown you earlier. Here we are using extras from device policy manager. So I have shown you only two, but there are plenty of actions or policies you have you can use. Like I have mentioned that minimum password, alphanumeric password, password quality, password expiration period, duration. Remote wipe, should there be a remote wipe facility or not, remote lock facility or not, camera should be disabled or not. Here are some code snippets to again use an intent to prompt the user, your employee, at any certain moment, if you want the user to reset the password, you can do that. So this can be, these policies cannot only be hard coded. This can be applied at runtime through network only. This is the main facilities of this manager. So you can set the password quality like alphanumeric and other digital or anything special characters, or set maximum time to lock. You want to set a duration, like if the device has been inactive for 5 minutes, the employee's device should be automatically be locked. So you can do that easily. Again, if you want at a certain moment of time to immediately lock the device of your employee at any place in the world, you can do that just by lock now, simple method. Data wipe, object device policy manager dot wipe data. Just wipe the data and set all the settings to factory settings. This here is an argument, currently it must be zero. Okay, that's it. So,
how the server-side implementation would be, supposing I want to lock the device now, so what would be the call that I do from the server side if I want to enable that policy, enforce that policy?
I have not worked on server-side code, but yeah, you can find, I have seen that code, you can find that code on in samples, Android samples, it is provided in the documents as in that, but I have worked on it. But there is not specific code, not some Android specific code for server side. So that is simple. That is just to communicate on with some specific messages for in response to some specific event.
Thank you.
With this device policy manager or the device administration API, are there any APIs with which we can configure VPN profiles or configure email accounts on a device?
These applications are just integrated into Android framework. You just buy a phone, you find those applications basic in settings. Okay. But there is you can create your custom application for doing that for your specific policies or other things, but for simple settings, you will find those applications in Android framework.
Just like how there is a lock now or a wipe data, is there a way that I can configure a VPN profile? So we have the native VPN profile configuration on Android, right? So there we can manually add VPN profiles.
Yes.
So is there an API that is there which can be used?
I'm not surely aware of specifically VPN settings, but I'm not sure if for specific VPN settings. But yeah, you can set others any general settings, policy related settings through your applications.
Okay. Thanks.
This whole device policy manager stuff, can it be effectively tested on emulators also?
No.
For example, wipe data.
For?
Wipe data.
Wipe data. I have not tested on emulator.
Because, I mean, this is not something that you will directly test it on the device. You have to do it first on an emulator.
I think, I doubt that in Froya there was not such. No, exactly. There is no. I remember there is no such kind of facility similar to Android emulators.
Okay.
In ICS, about ICS, I don't know, but earlier there was nothing.
So you need a device to
yes.
run these kind of or do some testing on these APIs.
Yes, real requests.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, we'll take one last question. You said that you have to have an application activated in order to take these calls into effect.
Yes.
So, what if someone uninstalls the application or doesn't activate at all? Will you have to write that application as a native one so that it starts when the phone boots? Or do you have any policies to make sure that the user starts?
Yes, there is a provision to integrate the application to phone boot, reboot. There are certain levels of this device admin policies application. This is your choice. What you want to do?
In the case that an employee uninstalls the application, would it keep the phone with himself?
Yes.
And
yes. Like there are two-way benefits for this admin application. If your employee has uninstalled the device, then he cannot connect to your email exchange, and if you can also introduce the code, if on installing, right on installing the device, you can just wipe the data.
Okay, so the thing is, if you anyhow uninstall the application from your phone becomes a